What's up, everybody? It's Nika the Shay coming back at you with another video. This video is going to be about living your best life now, so starting up and staying up. So if you want to know more about this topic, make sure you stay tuned. Now, before I get into the actual nitty-gritty of this video, let me go ahead and apologize. I know it's been about 2 weeks since I posted a video up, possibly 3 weeks. I'm not sure how long it's going to take me to edit this video. By the way, I want to apologize for that. It was the holidays, so I do wish everyone had a great Christmas. Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever you celebrate. I celebrate Christmas, so I hope you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Yes, so I had Christmas, and literally, I'm in school, I'm getting my master's online, and I submitted like my last assignment on Christmas Eve. So I had a pretty hectic 2 week final period, so I apologize for that. But I'm here and I'm back, and it actually just ties right in with the video that I have in store for you guys today about starting up and staying up. I'm gonna make it 3 simple things that you want to do to make sure that you're fulfilling. So the first thing you want to do is decide what it is that you want to do. So you can have a vision, a mission, or a goal, but whatever it is, just make sure you figure out what it is that you want to do and figure out why you want to do it. Because figuring out the why can help you a lot, especially as things start to get harder as you continue to do what it is that you're doing. Once you figure out your why, you want to go ahead and lay out your plan physically for you to see. So whether it be on Excel or just Word or just a vision board of some sort, just make sure you lay it out and have your starting point and where you ultimately desire to be, with the links connecting those two things, so that you can have as smooth of a transition as possible. And then once you have that, make sure you stick to that plan that you've created. And then once you have all that laid out, you want to go ahead and stick to it. So consistency is a big key. And even if you end up falling behind like I did, make sure you're able to pick back up from where you left off. So don't just end up like, oh, well, I missed a day, or I messed up on my eating pattern for a day. Don't let that discourage you from continuing to pursue and move forward. The second thing you want to do is act. So starting up is the hardest thing that you can do, because you can have like a great idea and it sounds really great. You're encouraged, you're motivated. But when it comes down to the action part of, oh, I'm really about to do this, like, you know, you get filled with a bunch of nerves and maybe a bit of doubt or whatever the case may be. And it kind of pushes you to not want to continue or to not even start it all together. So just make sure that you start. And once you start, things should become a lot easier. You also want to wrap your mind around and really understand yourself to know if you are outcome focused or process focused. So if you are process focused, you're more so going to be thinking about, oh, this makes me feel good. But if you're outcome focused, it's going to be, well, I'm doing this because I have to do what I have to do, which is a better mindset to have, because the reality of it is when you're doing something, things are not always going to be easy, and that's applicable to a lot of different areas. So let's say I'm trying to lose weight, for example. The process of losing that weight and exercising and eating right, like that in itself, does it feel good? But the outcome ultimately in the end is more beneficial than my complaint in the moment. A good example would be me starting this YouTube channel. I had this idea for 2 months. Once I started, it was just a matter of continuing, being consistent with it. And of course, I had that standstill because of finals, and I could look at that as the middle point. So at every starting point, there's a middle point, and there's a point where you're like, I'm either halfway where I desire to be, or I'm halfway to where I was. And at that point, it's easy to go either which way, but it's good to change your perspective in that time and look at it as, oh, I'm halfway to where I was, and just look at everything that you've done up until that point as a source of motivation to continue pushing forward. And then also, you want to make sure that you are creatively you in that process. We are all creative beings. We are all our own persons. What Jane or John might be doing to accomplish whatever outcome they were desiring even though it may look like my outcome, their journey is not going to be what my journey is. So whatever they've done to reach where they're at, me following those same exact steps is not gonna exactly take me to that same place. Like my our processes are gonna be completely different, even though the outcome may look the same. So make sure that you're creatively you and that you're comfortable in that, because being creatively you is what makes whatever you're doing different. And then the third thing is persevere. Persevering is the biggest thing, because you can start, but if you're not persevering and being consistent, then it's just like the start and then it just kind of, you know. So you want to make sure that you are running the right race and not a rat race, because when you are running a rat race, you're ultimately just working towards a measly reward, as opposed to this is ultimately fulfilling and it may take longer, but I'm doing this because it's satisfying to me and it's not, I'm just doing this because I'm trying to keep up with the Joneses. Then you also want to stay clear of the comparison trap, because it's very easy to compare yourself to others. We each in our lives have different loads that we carry. I'm gonna use this box as a metaphor. So you can't feel it because you're not here, but this box is pretty heavy right now, right? So if I open it, my box has a camera, some bowls, some keys, and a couple hooks. Somebody else's load can be different because all they have is bowls and hooks. They can have nothing in the box. So you want to stay clear of the comparison trap, because everyone, again, everyone's load is different. And I hope the box analogy kind of like helped with that into perspective. And you want to lighten your load if you have people around you as a community that will help lighten your load. Because in the process, you want to get rid of anything that's like hindering you. So if you have friends or naysayers in your corner, go ahead and remove them, because that's hindering you from what you're working towards. And you never know how good you're at something until you try. So once you've decided, make sure you act. And once you act, make sure you persevere. So go ahead and put yourself out there and just do it. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you follow me on Instagram. Like, share. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns, make sure to comment wherever it may be. Thanks for watching.